Namaskar. It looks like Intolerance gang is back again just before Lok Sabha elections. Yes, I am talking about Naseeruddin Shah. Naseeruddin Shah, in his recent interview to a TV channel, he mentioned that he is afraid of his kids' future. He also told not to be afraid, but to be angry. Even I was angry when he supported mercy plea for Yaqub Menon. Yaqub Menon is a terrorist. He killed innocent Indian citizens, yet you supported him? Why does media or social activists or people like you conveniently choose when to react and when not to react? Well, how many of you heard about Satyanarayana Murthy? Satyanarayana Murthy is a priest in one of the temples in Telangana. Just because he played morning Suprabhat prayers in the temple, he was beaten by a Muslim clerk. Later, while undergoing treatment, he died in hospital. Yet, this was not covered in any national media, even in the local media. Even in the local media, this news was suppressed that it did not reach a lot of people. Why does media always selectively choose what to show and what not to show to the people? If it happened the other way, all the Awad Wapsi gang, Intolerance gang, social activists and media would have made a national issue out of it, doing debates 24/7 in the channels. So why does media always have to follow the false propaganda and do the selective outrage? So why doesn't this people petrify during 1992 riots on 26/11 attacks? Why aren't they petrified or angry when lakhs of Kashmir pandits were kicked out from Kashmir? In 2012, 2 lakh Muslims came onto Azad Maidan. They attacked a lot of police men and women, and they even destroyed Amar Jeevan Jyoti. There are several such incidents where these people, they choose to be mum, not to talk about it, not to react. Weren't you annoyed then? Weren't you petrified then? Weren't you insecure then? Weren't you angry then? And a few days back, Amir Ansari, being in Pakistan jail for almost 6 years, he came back to India. Ansari's mom told, Meri Bharat Mahan, Meri Madam Mahan, Sab Madam ne hi kiya hai. She's so happy meeting her son after 6 long years. And looking at a video like this and the statements like this doesn't make you feel that you are secure? Doesn't make you feel proud that you belong to a country like this? And why does luxurious people who actually have got fame and name, just because that we supported you people, we loved you without judging, and now you're showing your real face and that is how you pay off our love? And why is it not common man who is always not scared, but the elite people with luxurious cars and always security around them is so insecure? To be frank and honest, I feel more secure than ever. The government has amended rape law, and whoever is involved in a minor girl rape will be hanged to death. Yes, in fact, I feel more secure because government has implemented, and it is implementing, NRC for the first time in history, and that will send out all Rohingyas. And we undoubtedly know how cruel these Rohingyas are. Yes, I feel more secure because I haven't heard or seen any bomb blast in the past 4.5 years. So, yes, I feel more secure under the leadership of Narendra Modi. Bharat Mata Ki Jai, Jai Hind, Jai Shri Ram.